We're going to get a melting point of this compound we've just recrystallised. A melting point tube can be made by sealing the end of a capillary tube. Hold the tube at 45 degrees with the end at the top of the blue cone of the Bunsen flame and gently turn the tube. You want to seal the end but not heat it so much that a glass ball is formed on the end of the tube. This will make it hard to insert into the melting point apparatus. The easiest way to get your compound into the melting point tube is to put a small amount onto a watch glass and press the open end of the tube onto the solid to create a small plug in the end of the tube. You can either flick the tube or bounce it gently on the bench to get the solid to the bottom of the tube. You only need a few crystals. Put it into the melting point apparatus and turn the heater to 3 or 4. Don't be tempted to turn it to 9 or 10, as you'll overshoot the melting point and you'll get an inaccurate value. Don't be tempted to use a rapid heat either for the same reason. Watch the solid until you just see it starting to shrink from the side of the tube. And that's the first sign it's starting to melt. You need to take a range of the melting point, so record the temperature at which it starts and finishes melting.